Welcome to my channel. In today's video, I will be sharing with you my top 5 most repurchased beauty products. So without any delays, let's jump right into it. The first product that I will be speaking to you about is a Loreal Brow Stylist Definer. And I did fill in my brows with this pencil today. This is usually my go-to. I do wear the color brunette, and this is just an ultra fine tip pencil for your brows. It is very, very precise. I just love it. Here's the swatch right here. With this, I usually don't struggle. If I want to do my brows the quickest and the sharpest, nicest way possible, I usually gravitate towards this pencil right here. I like it better than the thicker ones that they sell at the store, the ones that kind of look like a triangular shape. I did buy the L'Oreal one just to try it, and I do like this one better. This one does remind me of the Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Wiz. After discovering this product, I never again repurchased that one. And I'll be quite honest with you, this is probably my most repurchased product in this video, period. I usually have backups of this product. I buy them when I find them on sale, and I run through these pretty quickly, but again, it is my favorite brow product. Sticking to the eye theme, I will be sharing my favorite eyeliner with you, and again, I am wearing it today. It is the Essence Eyeliner Pen in Waterproof. I do choose the color black, and it's this one right here. Let me swatch it for you very quickly. Here's a swatch on my hand, and this is just a very black, gorgeous eyeliner. Again, because of the tip, I feel like it is very easy for me to handle and for me to wear. This is probably, again, very loved because of the convenience that it gives me, the comfort it offers me. I know that if I use this, I'm probably going to get a nice wing. It is very difficult for me to do wing eyeliner sometimes, but this product just facilitates the process for me, and for that reason I really, really enjoy it. Not to mention that it is matte and it is a very black eyeliner. For those reasons, I really, really enjoy this product. The wonderful thing about it too is that it is worth about $2 to $3, and every time I place an Ulta order, I basically order another one of these because, again, it is one of my go-to products. Another one of the products that I cannot live without is the Wet n Wild Mega Glow Contouring Palette. And as you can see, I've already finished the shade right here, the highlighting shade. And this is clearly my favorite bronzer. This bronzer I rarely use. I don't get a lot of use out of this one right here, but the banana shade is my favorite to set my under eyes. For the Dulce de Leche contour palette right here, I really enjoy the Dulce de Leche color, the one that they put right here, the beige one. I do use it to set my under eyes when I want something that's not that yellow, but this contour shade is my favorite. It's just matte. It's not too cool. It's not too warm. I am wearing it right now. It is one of my favorite contour shades from the drugstore. I just really, really enjoy this product. And from the Caramel Toffee, this one right here, my go-to shade is the banana shade. I do use this shade to bronze once in a while, but rarely, because I think that this color right here gives me more of an orangey bronze, and I do not like that. This bronzer right here gives me more of a, I don't know, more of an even bronzing contour effect. That is why I keep on repurchasing these palettes, because I feel like the powders are very fine, they are silky, and they are beautiful to set your under eyes, and of course to bronze up your face. As you can see, I have 2 palettes right here, and you can bet that I've repurchased both of these multiple times. Just in case you're wondering, the lip color I'm wearing right now is this Milani lip liner in the color Spice. And this lip liner has been repurchased by me many times, and it will be repurchased by me a million times more. This is my favorite nude lip liner. It's kind of like a terracotta brown. It gives me enough warmness. It gives me enough color. I don't like nude lipsticks or nude lip liners that make you look like a ghost, that basically just eliminate the color from your lips. I feel like this color is my lips, but better, perhaps a little darker than my lips. But I really, really enjoy these type of brownish terracotta colors overall when it comes to blush, lipstick, lip liners, and even eyeshadows. I really enjoy warm colors, so it is not a surprise to me that this is my favorite lip liner. Again, I've bought it a lot of times and I will keep on repurchasing it multiple times more. If you want to know about the formula is extremely creamy. It doesn't tug on your lips. It slides beautifully and comfortably. And of course, the color is a win-win for me. So if you're on the hunt for a nude, brownish, terracotta color, try the Spice Lip Liner by Milani. It is my favorite. It is one of my go-to lip liners. To finish this video off, I will be sharing with you my most repurchased setting spray. And it is the Milani Make It Last Setting Spray. This is just a very, very gorgeous, finely mist setting spray. For that reason, I keep on repurchasing it. If you look at it logically, it is not that cheap. It is a drugstore setting spray, but you are paying $10 for 2 ounces. For the MAC Fix Plus setting spray, you do pay more, but you do get about twice the product that this offers right here. So if you compare the setting spray to high-end ones, the price is not that cheap. It's not that flexible, but I do really enjoy the scent of this product. I do feel like it helps the longevity of my makeup, and I enjoy the fine mist that it sprays. Again, this is my most repurchased setting spray. And I'll be honest with you, as of lately, I have been reaching for the MAC Fix Plus a little more, but that's simply because I've been having more troubles with my dry areas. And I feel like the MAC Fix Plus offers me some type of moisture when this product doesn't really do that for me. So as of recently, I am enjoying the MAC Fix Plus a little more simply because of the hydration factor, but this is definitely a wonderful setting spray as well. We've come to the end of this video. Hopefully you found it helpful. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Hit that bell button for notifications, and I'll see you around next time. Have a wonderful day, a beautiful evening, a very delightful night. Goodbye.